Now we have the council staff submission on draft LGNZ 2050 local government position on climate change, and would someone like to move that we adopt the staff submission as our own? I know that it's had input from many councillors, so Pauline moved, seconded Phil.
Can I just have a question?
Oh, well, I've put... Oh, okay. Yep.
Sorry, we canvassed this briefly this morning. Just on page 32, when the LGNZ one looks at advocacy for change, I'd put like our submission to state that, because it says here, there are also opportunities for other sectors, including central government, to support the local government contribution. I think that the submission should say that it's essential for other sectors. Local government can't do it alone. It's not just there's opportunities for others to act on climate change, but everyone needs to. So I think we need to strengthen that one.
So whereabouts is that?
Page 32. I think we should add that to our submission.
32.
Under the advocacy for change one. Because currently it says that while there is scope for local government to take responsibility for the management of climate change, there are also opportunities for other sectors. But actually, it's essential that other sectors take part as well.
So responsibilities?
Yeah, responsibilities. Yeah.
All right. Dave,
easy to know. Yep.
Just a question on the... letter that's going with the submission. In section one in the introduction, we talk at the end of that paragraph about adaption and mitigation has become a matter of urgency for Greater Christchurch, particularly for our coastal settlements. Then if we go forward to some of the bullet points we're talking about, under the bullet point, local government seeks clarification as where fiscal responsibility lies for adoption. Our submission is saying that we support this opportunity, which is essential if managed retreat and adaptive pathways to realigning coastal settlements are to be viable options for communities. And I'm just wondering whether those two, the introduction's consistent with that bit. And then further in that same paragraph, we are suggesting that we amend a sentence to include a paragraph need to be considered as a matter of urgency as effects of climate change are already being felt in the form of increased flooding and exacerbated erosion on our coasts. I support the general thrust of what we are proposing in the submission, but I question really whether it particularly relates to Christchurch in terms of exacerbated erosion and the talk of managed retreat in relationship to adaptation and mitigation.
So just to address your first point, Councillor East, in terms of the adaptation and mitigation, adaptation is used there in a very broad sense, so it could include either measures through our district plan, which we already have in place, such as raised floor levels and discouraging development in very high risk areas. It could also include in the future such options as managed realignment, so it's used in a very broad sense there. In terms of the recommendation on the second point about the increased flooding and exacerbated erosion on our coasts, that's a suggested recommendation to the Local Government New Zealand statement, which pertains to the whole of New Zealand, so that's not a description of Christchurch, but that's a reality in terms of the whole of New Zealand, and there are certainly other parts of New Zealand that have exhibited accelerated erosion that we haven't yet felt. The Hawke's Bay coast would be a good example of a very vulnerable coast where there's been an acceleration in erosion in the last few years.
Yep. Any other questions? Right, any discussion?
Concern that we as a council in this particular document are still signalling our position on managed retreat adaptive pathways to realigning, and that we are signalling to our coastal community positions that are different to the policy you're trying to establish here. I think we are signalling to our communities a preemptive response to climate change in this document. Well, managed retreat, exacerbated erosion.
Phil, Yanni, Glenn?
Well, look, my view is that Local Government New Zealand have put forward a really good case, which is this is based on, and that what the staff, the way the staff have added to this actually has been, is really effective. I think it's extremely important. I think what Councillor East has just expressed is almost certainly a minority view around the table. Clearly, climate change is happening right now as we debate this, and I think it's great that we are moving progressively, and in effect will help create a campaign on this too to get it right. And around people being displaced, for example, well, I think it's really important that we take that into account, and that people along the coast in fact will benefit from that, because there is, it does, the question about cost and responsibility for that is being raised, and that is something that this whole country needs to address. And I'm particularly impressed by the additional factors that our staff have added in. We have debated the petroleum drilling, and in fact have made a submission on that, and that will be included with this submission. And also just the change effects that are being held right now, which I referred to, and particularly around how in fact we, climate change in fact, we've got the multi-hazards, we're taking that approach, and part of, you know, besides sea level rise, we have got flooding and we have got storms, and in fact I think this is a really good document that I'm hoping council will strongly support.
Sorry, who did I say next? Yanni, then Glenn.
Yeah, thank you. I mean, I thought it was good that staff had as basically saying that you need to take a holistic view to the cost, both to communities and to how things are paid for if that does happen. I didn't take it to mean that that would happen, but I think one of the criticisms we faced around the coastal hazards chapter was the lack of analysis around the social and the economic impacts of land use.
where fiscal response. To misrepresent to our coastal communities what this document is all about and what our response is about. Central government needs to lead the conversation about allocating responsibilities, including fiscal responsibility, for adapting to climate change. The effects of climate change, such as rising sea levels, create a new set of social, economic, and political challenges for as the effects of climate change are already being felt in the form of increased flooding and exacerbated erosion on our coasts. So, and actually, we could actually talk about cliff claps as well and rockfall risk, because in those areas, in terms of seeing those communities having to be responded to in the wake of a disaster, and we are seeing it repeated in Kaikoura as we speak. So I feel very strongly about this, and I think it would be highly irresponsible for anyone to communicate to our existing communities, our coastal communities who've been through so much, that this in any way states a position on managed retreat. Christchurch City Council does not have a policy on managed retreat. We may need to develop one, but that will be in the future. And we will do that in conjunction with our communities. But as this says, what communities? Because who pays? And that's what Local Government New Zealand is asking us to consider. So I'm very grateful for the work that staff have done on this submission, but I really do want to say, please don't participate in any discussion that says that our council has adopted a position that we haven't. And we have to recognise that there are extremely challenging issues left for us to confront when we do the coastal hazards chapter, and it ain't going to help if people are raising these issues in this way to cause fear in our communities. There's no need to confront this with fear. We've got time, we've got the energy, and we've certainly got the commitment to do our bit and to get it right. But it's this council that's going to take responsibility for working with communities to define what that will look like. Local Government New Zealand is saying we've got to get this right for the rest of the country as well. So on that note, I will put that resolution. All those in favour say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed say no. That is carried.